Hi, this is Debbie House, editor of Retail Touchpoints at the NRF 2012 Big Show, and I'm here today with Mark Kelso, who's the director of pricing at Pomida Stores. Welcome and thanks for joining us
today. Thank you. Pleased to meet you, Debbie.
Mark and I are standing in front of the Revionics booth because Mark is doing some work with Revionics, and he's agreed to just chat with us for a few minutes about some of what you do. And the first thing I want to ask you, Mark, if you can just give us a little bit of background on Pomida,
okay.
And then we'll move on.
Pomida is a Midwest regional retailer. We have 193 stores, mostly in small rural towns. We have a wide variety of products, including we do have pharmacies, we sell consumables, we have apparel, home goods, sporting goods, a lot of hard and soft goods related to that. And we have a foundation that actually contributes to the communities that we serve. We're very proud of.
So in that regard, is your pricing structure a bit complex?
It can be. And actually, prior to having optimization, we were experiencing changes in our shopping pattern that we're moving away from everyday shopping to more promotional. You know, I think when in 2008, when the economy started to falter, consumers started buying more promotional goods, they started shopping multiple stores, and they were really looking for the deals.
Right.
And so we did see that they were shopping more on a promotional basis and not less on an everyday basis. So we knew that we weren't resonating value on an everyday standpoint. So what we did was looked at how price optimization could help us improve our everyday value proposition and be a win-win both for us and for our consumer so that they would shop every day and rely less on our promotional offerings.
So what did Revionics offer for you when you were going through that process?
Well, Revionics actually offered us the ability to manage the unmanageable. You think about all the data you have coming in sales and units and margin data from all your transactions. It's almost impossible to try to analyze anything on a manual basis. So it helps us take what is very complex and put it into fairly simple terms so that we can understand it, look at trends, and read consumer sentiment signals so that we can set strategies that are appropriate for both us from a profitability standpoint and drive consumer behavior to buy more, to actually get better deals overall. Because at the end of the day, it's the end of the receipt that impresses the consumer. So it was really trying to drive more traffic in on an everyday basis.
So when was the implementation and what results have you seen?
We actually started in July of last year, and we did a proof of concept first because we wanted to kind of test it without betting the farm, so to speak. So we did a configuration that took until about October. Then we tested a small group of stores and had a control group from October till January. Once we had the results in from that, they were positive, so we did a full rollout starting in April. So we've been on optimization across our network since April of this year.
Okay, and are there any metrics or results or ROIs you can share?
Absolutely, yeah, you got to measure everything. Yeah. And what we found was that, we were trying to bolster up our everyday shopping experience, so it was really about base sales. Our base sales from the 90-day period prior to implementation to the third 90-day period after implementation has increased 2,300 basis points, which is 23%.
Yeah, that's
so basically,
impressive.
If we were at a 0% comp, we were at a 23.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, it was fantastic.
How did the optimization solution help you during the holidays? Were there any surprises there or any,
Not specifically surprises. What it does is it looks at all your items. It does look at seasonality and it adjusts for seasonality. So it's actually behind the scenes, and it makes sense once you look at the data, but you may or may not know that it's really doing those things. So it was a seamless process, and actually in the month of December we had comps on our base of about 14%. Our total comps, which includes promotion, were around 8. So it was a fantastic season for us. We actually exceeded most of the retail arena out there.
That's great. Well, thanks so much for sharing.
Well, thanks for asking.
And congratulations. And
thank you.
Thanks to all of you for joining us today on Touchpoints TV. Have a great day.